So here we have a whole hunkel lamb. We're gonna bone roll this into one big long roast. So butterflied, then legs rolled into the loins, the shoulders rolled, and then that's either how you can do it for a spit, or as I'm gonna do, I'll just cut it up into normal roasts. This is in my shed, so it's not a perfect environment, but it's how I do it because it's for me to eat. So, first things first, open her up. She's a little bit cold because she's been in the freezer. From the brisket down to the neck. Just gotta be a bit careful because my tripod wants to fall over and then my phone will fall over. So I start here, down the side of the brisket. Again, our goal is to butterfly this so there's no holes in anything. But if you do put a hole on one side, you're just going to make that the internal. It's a bit difficult because she's still a little bit frozen, but you should be right. That side's very frozen. Hopefully we can deal with that once it comes to it. Fillets. Pull our fillets out. Here I've opened up the back leg joint there. Slowly making my way down the ribs, down the neck. If you end up with a couple of these little bones, don't stress too much because you can always cut that out once it's actually opened up. So now we just want to get under here, try to get under these feather bones, all the way down the backbone. Again, without, we don't want to break the backbone, get the meat onto the skin onto the back. That side's pretty much done. That's that. I don't know how much you can actually see. I've cleared all the way down here. I'll put a little bit more there now. Okay. too worried about, because after you end up cutting it off anyway, because it's just a pain. So that's that. Now, we start on this other side, which is pretty hard, but hopefully we can work it without making a mess of it. Or making a mess of anything else. Definitely a challenge with this being half frozen, but again, this is for my own consumption, so I don't care how close I get to it. I can breathe all over all I want. Just flat, that's frozen solid, which is making this difficult, but we will get there. Don't mind the dog, he's scavenging and it bugs me. See, this stuff is frozen solid almost, so it is a bit difficult. When you do that, you go straight through the side of it, but that's fine, we can deal with that. One side's good, so. The feather bones here. I would have done this straight out of the chiller, but I couldn't leave it hanging because of flies at the moment are absolutely ridiculous. So everything has to be done the second it's out. Hence the reason I'm doing it still half broken. Slowly work our way down around the backbone. And once you can get underneath, you're away laughing. Set butterflied off, which is not perfect, but just rock solid. And that's our butterflied lamb. I'll go through don't care too much about the fillets. Any excess or excess fat you don't want. This is the bit that's a bit annoying, is the neck is all weird like that, so I normally tend to just cut it off like that. Cut this stuff here out. This brisket fat. Let's get our shins around there. That's one. That's two. Then open these up. Either each way, it really does not matter. This is just getting rolled in. I do find it's definitely easier to open bone it, not tunnel bone it. Back legs done, now shoulders. The shoulder might be a bit difficult, but we'll see what happens. a marker on that. Now I do tunnel bone my shoulders. And this. This will be the hardest part about this whole thing, is getting your blade bones out without doing any other damage. Nick around blade bone, you can tend to pull it off. Now we'll see what we can do here. Clear enough in here. That shoulder done. Now, that's our whole butterflied lamb. Now, if you've made any cuts in your flaps, which I did there, you make sure you roll from that side. So, now, I find where me, there it is there. So that's your leg into your rump, goes into there. I cut down the flap, open that up. Cut this big bit of fat out. That, and then from here halfway in, halfway up, fold that in till it reaches your shoulders, and that should be all about right there. I'm going to guess it, and exactly the same on this side. Got a bit of fat, cut that out. Halfway in, halfway through. Do that. Now, that side there, get this, and I'll use this to roll all that in tight. And then you check here, so I've got a little bit of like dead space there. So it might mean that I need to stretch that out a bit. Backbone of your sheep. Quite careful how I do these initial skewers up so you don't tear too much skin. Done up, I'll adjust them all to make them a bit tighter or a bit looser wherever they have to be. So don't do that. So when you do that, you get a change position. This does have a slight incline on the shoulder side. It is slightly thicker than the other side, but it's not going to split this one, so it's not the end of the world. Now I sew all my roasts, so backbone helps on this. I start from, I find a nice comfortable level I want to start from. Inside of the first skewer, straight through, come around, I rotate it. Right through, back through the middle again. Now if you're doing this for a spit, I recommend pulling your string right back around as it comes back over the top. That nice and tight. Roll down low. All I do, pull my string down. Pull that string up through the middle, pull it around, finger there like that, rotate, rotate, back through. Now you can use your hands or you can use the end of your knife, couple like that. Don't pull too tight if you're using your knife because you will snap the string. Wrap it around. Set one tied. And if you always start from your thicker end down to your thinner end, you're likely to push it along a bit, so that will help you a little bit too. So again, down low where I want. If you're not putting it on a spit or you don't care, you don't have a lot of twine, just don't worry about the full loop around again. Or if you want to get fancy, think about the size of your roasts. So if that's how big I want my roast, apart from the end here, because that will be trimmed, I can make this one here a wraparound, and then that means each end of my roast, when I cut it, will be wrapped up tight. Around, then through the middle, up like that, two fingers each side so the string can pull through, pinch, then around, around, back through the middle. And if anyone comments on my strings aren't straight or my knots aren't straight, I really don't care. Because again, this isn't going in a cabinet to look flash. This is getting cut up to go in my freezer. If I was doing this for a spit, I would pack the strings in a little bit tighter, a bit closer together, just to give it that little bit of extra strength for when it's going around and around. So I'd say probably another third of the amount of strings I'd put in. But I don't really have a formula for stringing them, I just string them and I'd deal with it when it comes to it. And if I have a couple of roasts bigger than the others, not worried, because you just leave them for when you've got family coming around or friends or something like that. See, it is sunken a wee bit here, but can't rely on that because half of the sheep is still frozen, so I'll deal with that when it comes to cutting it up. Just means it'll be a bit of a weird roast. I'm telling you, my grandfather would be rolling in his grave with the amount of string I'm wasting leaving on the end of these knots, but he's not here to tell me otherwise. And I pay for it, so it also doesn't matter. As you can see, obviously, I only done those two loops. So it's up to you where you could chuck another string through there and you sort of half roast, but that bit tends to be pretty sloppy. And that's how I like my roast. Plenty of fat in them, stay moist. Nice and big. And this is the one that kind of fell in on itself, but also not that bad. And yeah, that's how I do it anyway. Oh, better give a shout out to Victory Knives, except for my one Victorinox.